Now, our next topic is short circuit of a synchronous machine or short circuit of a alternator or transient analysis of alternator. So before we go through this, let's understand one concept. What happens inside synchronous machine when fault appears? Okay. So see here. This is a transformer, okay, and the primary side of a transformer is connected to a current source I of t, okay, and the behavior of this current is plotted here. So from 0 to t1 current increases, right? So this current will produce flux, phi, and this flux will also change, okay, will also increase, okay, this flux will also increase from phi to phi m, okay. Now due to this change in flux, a voltage should be appear in the windings, but due to open circuit, this is open circuit, right? This is open circuit. So because of open circuit, the current in secondary will be equal to zero. Current in secondary is equal to zero, right? So because current in the secondary winding is zero, there will be no counter flux produced by secondary winding. Okay, so suppose the time taken by flux to reach maximum value is tau 1. Now, what about in second case? This is first case and this is second case. What happened in second case when your transformer is loaded? Okay, so from 0 to t1, current increases and this current will produce flux, okay, flux, and due to change in flux, voltage get induced in the second winding, and because load is connected here, current will flow in the secondary winding, and because of this current, flux will produce in the secondary winding, phi s. Since here load is high, so if load is high, this current will be low and the flux produced by this current is low, right? So this flux will oppose your main flux because action always opposed by its cause, right? So this flux will oppose main flux. So here in the second condition, phi will change to phi m, it will reach to phi m at time t2, but it will take more time than t1. If I compare this condition with t1, it will take more time, right? So here t1 is less than t2. See, if I compare with the first case, there was no opposition. So phi reached to phi m at time t1. In second case, there is opposition. There is opposition, but the value of opposition is less, right? So phi will reach to phi m at time t2. But if I compare this condition, second condition, with the first condition, then phi will take more time than first condition. Now come to third condition. See here, if you give current from 0 to t1 in third condition, If you give current from 0 to T1, what happen? In the primary winding, it will produce flux. Why? Since this flux is changing, right? This flux is changing. So due to this change in flux, voltage will get induced in this winding. Right? Because this resistance is low, the current in the secondary winding will be higher as compared to second case. Right? Here resistance is more, so current is less. Here resistance is less, so current is more. Right? So here due to this current, due to secondary current, a counter flux will be produced by the secondary winding. Since this current is more, secondary current is more, this phi s will be more. Now phi will take more time to reach phi m. Okay, suppose in this condition it took time T3. So according to this, since opposition is more than in secondary case, this time will be more compared to second case. Right? So if I see what we analyzed here, in no load condition, this was the time taken by flux to reach phi m. Now if you increase the load condition, if your transformer is loaded, then it will take more time to reach phi m. But if the transformer is loaded with lesser value of R resistance, then it will take more time than compared to both condition. Right? It will take more time for phi to reach phi m. Okay. So the same thing, same concept we are going to carry in synchronous machine. So the same condition we are going to carry in synchronous machine. What happened in synchronous machine? See, under no load condition, this is the flux in air gap, right? And this is the EMF induced because of this flux, right? Now is loaded, how we plot?
Suppose this machine is loaded,
then this will be IA, right? And because of this field MMF, write your field MMF. Your field MMF is FF, suppose. So because of IA, there will be FAR, right? Because of IA, there will be FAR, and the resultant of FF plus FAR will be your resultant MMF, FR. Okay. Now, when short circuit appear at this section, when short circuit appear, then this IA will become IF. Okay, here current will rise. Now, if IA will rise, if the current will rise, here in such condition, FF will take more time to reach FR, right? What we saw in transformer, if current rises, the flux will take more time to reach phi m, right? So if current rises, FF will take more time to reach FR, right? So under this condition, under this period, we analyze transient. Okay, under this period, we analyze transient. Okay, since current rises, right? So if current rises, this field MMF will take more time to reach FR, right? So if we take more time, if we take more time to reach FR, it means there is opposition in the main field, right? There is opposition in the air gap MMF, right? That's why it is taking more time to reach FR. Now what happened? Flux cannot change instantaneously. Okay, flux cannot change instantaneously. It will take some time. Okay, under no load condition, what was the field MMF? That is FF under no load condition. Under no load condition, what will be the, what was the field MMF? That is FF. Now, under loaded condition, it doesn't take lot of time, right? Quickly, it changed from FF to FR. It took less time. Now, if short circuit appear here, the current will rise. If the current will rise, it will take more time to reach FR, right? So, what happened under this period? See. When fault appear, the flux will change from FF to FR. The flux will change from FF to FR. If there is a change of flux, if there is change of flux appear in air gap, if there is a change of flux appear in air gap, the damper bar winding which is placed in rotor, the damper bar winding which is placed in rotor, here it is damper bar winding, right? So if the damper bar winding which is placed in rotor experience this change in flux, a voltage will get induced in this, right? If damper bar winding experience change in flux, if damper bar winding experience change in flux, voltage will get induced. Right, since damper bar winding are shorted, right, the end of the damper bar winding is shorted, so because of this current will flow, current will flow in damper bar winding, right, and because of this current, because of this current, it will produce a flux. Because of this current, it will produce flux, right? Which oppose the main flux, okay? Because of this current flow in damper bar winding, it will produce flux, and this flux will oppose the main flux, right? Main MMF. Now, in the same way, when MMF changes from FF to FR, this field winding, okay, this is damper bar winding, this is damper bar winding, and this is field winding. So, if MMF changes from FF to FR, if MMF changes from FF to FR, this field winding also experiences change of flux. Okay, if this field winding experiences change of flux, if the field winding experience change of flux, then voltage will get induced in the field winding, across field winding. Right? So because of this voltage, current will flow in field winding. Right? So because of this current, field winding produce a counter flux, right? Field winding produce a counter flux. Okay, and this flux will oppose your main flux, main MMF, right? Field MMF. So there, as you can see, there are two opposition to the field MMF, right? One is produced by the damper bar winding and one is produced by the field winding. So field winding. Now, suppose the main MMF is opposed by two flux. One is damper bar winding and another is field winding. Okay. If the main MMF is opposed by two flux, that condition we call as subtransient. Okay, if the main field MMF is opposed by two flux, one is with damper bar, one is produced by damper bar winding and another is produced by field winding. If the main field MMF is opposed by two flux, that condition we call as subtransient condition. Now, if I talk about damper bar winding, now, in damper bar winding, number of turns are less. Number of turns are less. Right? Now, what is time constant? L by R. Right? If number of turn is less, so L will be less, okay, and in damper bar winding resistance is more, so we can tell that this time constant will be less, okay, as compared to field winding, as compared to field winding. In field winding, number of turns is more. Right, number of turns is more, okay, and in field winding resistance is less, right? For the field winding resistance is less, so if resistance is less, the time constant will be more, right? So what happened in damper bar winding? Time constant is less, right? And in field winding time constant is more. So if time constant of damper bar winding is less, if time constant of damper bar winding is less, then the opposition because of damper bar winding will die out soon, right? Opposition because of damper bar winding will die out soon. Okay, so after this, what will be the opposition left to the field MMF, or sorry, main MMF, that is flux produced by field winding, right? So if only one flux opposes field main MMF, if only one flux opposes main MMF, that condition we call as transient condition. Okay, transient condition. See what happened? Initially, what happened? FF will try to change to FR and it will take more time, right? Under this period, we'll call this condition as transient condition, right? We call this period as a transient period. Now, what happened in transient period? Since FF try to change to FR, due to this change, this damper bar winding will experience this change in flux, and because of this, a voltage will get induced in this damper bar winding, right? And because of that voltage, a current will flow in this damper bar winding, and because of that current, a flux will produce which will oppose the main MMF, right? Similarly, if FF try to change to FR, this field winding will experience this change, right? Because of this change in flux, voltage will get induced across this field winding, and because of this voltage, current will flow in this field winding, and because of this current, a counter flux will produce which will oppose the field MMF, right? So if two flux is opposing, if two flux is opposing field MMF, that condition we call as subtransient condition. Now, what happened with damper bar winding? See, the time constant of damper bar winding is less because number of turn is less. If number of turn is less, L value will be less, and in damper bar winding, resistance is more. Okay, resistance is more. But in field winding, time constant is more, right? Here, damper bar winding, time constant is less, so it will die out soon. Okay, and only field winding will be there which opposes the main MMF, right? So if one flux will oppose the main MMF, that condition we call as transient. If two flux will oppose the main MMF, that condition we call as subtransient condition. Okay, now after that, after few time, opposition provided by field winding will be eliminated . Okay, so after that we will get steady state condition. Steady state condition. Okay. Now, how we represent steady state condition of a synchronous machine? See. There will be leakage reactance, armature reactance, and this will be EF. Or I write it outside. EF. Okay. I represent this with a reactance value XT. Okay. So when short circuit appear, when short circuit appear, at that time current increase, right? When short circuit appear, that time current increase. So when this current will increase, when IA will increase, when the reactance offered by this path is less, will be lower, right? At that time, your current will rise. What we saw in transformer. If resistance will be less, current will be more, right? So if the reactance value offered by this path is less, then your current will rise, right? So under subtransient condition, under subtransient condition, under subtransient condition, what will be the subtransient reactance value? That is XT double dash. Okay, so what happened in subtransient condition? The reactance offered by damper bar winding and field winding will reduce the overall XT value, right? So under subtransient condition, this is XL and this is EF. So the reactance offered by damper bar winding and field winding will reduce the overall armature reactance. So we will connect this in parallel so that damper bar winding and field winding will reduce the overall armature reactance, right? So what will be the XT double dash? That is subtransient reactance, that is XL plus 1 by 1 divided by XTW plus 1 divided by reactance offered by field winding plus 1 divided by reactance offered by armature winding, right? So if you connect this in parallel, the overall XT value will decrease, okay? Now, what happened in transient condition? Okay, so in transient condition, the flux opposed by damper bar winding will die out soon, right? The flux opposed damper bar winding will die out soon. So what is left here? That will be reactance offered by field winding, right? So under transient condition, current will decrease little bit, okay? Because the reactance value is increased since we have removed this path, right? We have remove this path, Okay, so if you remove this path, the overall reactance value will increase. Okay, we have eliminated a parallel path. So the overall reactance value will increase. So overall, if reactance value will increase, then the current will decrease. Right? So transient reactance will be equal to XL plus 1 by XA plus 1 by XF. Right? Now after this, when both the flux die out or opposition provided by both the flux is eliminated, then your system will reach to steady state condition. Okay, so when damper bar winding was there, then current increased, right? Both damper bar winding and field winding was there, then current is increased. After that, the current offered by damper bar winding is eliminated. The current due to damper bar winding is eliminated because damper bar winding, the effect of damper bar winding will die out soon. The only thing left off, that is field winding, right? So how we plot this? See how we plot this. See, this is the steady state current. Now, this is the current offered by damper bar winding. So after few time, damper bar winding will die out soon, right? This is the current provided by damper bar winding. Okay, so after few time, damper bar winding will be no longer in the picture, right? And this is the current offered by field winding. Okay, this is the current offered by field winding. Okay, so what will be the overall current? See, at t is equal to 0, the overall current will be get added, right? At t is equal to 0, both damper bar winding and field winding will be there in picture. So after few time, damper bar winding will be no longer there. What we left? We left with field winding. So after this time, there will be current due to field winding. Right? So till here, damper bar will be there. Till here, damper bar will be there. After this, damper bar winding will be no longer and we left with field winding. Right? And after both the field winding and damper bar winding eliminated, we are left with steady state current. Okay, we left with steady state current. So if I draw so believe me or not, it took a lot of time to make this sine wave. Okay, so this is not appropriate, I know. Just bear with me. Okay, so this is a transient condition, subtransient condition. Okay, so under subtransient condition, as you can see, both current is appear, right? The current due to damper bar winding and current due to field winding, right? Current due to field winding, both appeared, right? Okay, so in subtransient condition, both appeared, that's why the overall current increased. Okay, that's why here you can see the overall current increased. This is a current due to damper bar winding, and this is the current due to field winding. So overall current will increase. This is not the current provided by damper bar winding. Inside the damper bar winding, make it sure that the reactance offered by this damper bar flux, damper bar produced flux, which opposes the main MMF, right? So the reactance offered by this damper bar winding increase the current. Okay, so due to this current is increased because of damper bar winding, and this current is increased because of field winding. So till subtransient, both the current will be there. Now after that, as you can see, damper bar winding will be no longer in the transient section because the time constant of damper bar winding is less. Okay, so the flux offered by the damper bar winding will die out soon, and the reactance offered by damper bar winding will be no longer in the picture. So the current will only carried by due to field winding. Okay, so here current increased due to field winding. From this point, the current is due to field winding, and this region is called transient region. Okay, please don't get confused in that this current is the current in damper bar winding and this current is the current in field winding. Okay, this current increase because of damper bar winding, because damper bar winding reduce the overall reactance value of armature. Okay, because of that current increased. Okay, and this is the current because of field winding. Okay, because field winding provided you a reactance which reduced the overall reactance of armature. Okay, so because of this, IA increases. Okay, this is the armature current. So IA increases. So after subtransient condition, after subtransient region, field due to damper bar winding will die out, and you left with the effect of field winding. Okay, so after this, when both the effect is no longer in the picture, this region is called, and this region will be steady state region, right? At this region, your current will reach to normal value IA. Initially, when short circuit appeared, the current value was IF. Now, at this region, okay. Suppose what we saw initially, when there was no short circuit and this was open, okay, machine was kept under no load condition. At that time, what was the current? Zero, because at that time there will be no current. Current will be equal to zero, IA will be equal to zero, right? The moment short circuit appear at this point, the moment short circuit appear, then the resistance offered by this path is very low, right? The resistance offered by this path is very low, due to which current rises, right? When short circuit appear, then the resistance, armature resistance is very less, right? So the current will rise to IF. Here armature resistance is very less, so current will rise to IF. Your armature current will become IF, right? And what was the field MMF under no load condition? Field MMF or air gap MMF. This is the air gap MMF. That is under no load condition was FF. When fault appear, this field MMF will try to reduce from FF to FR. It means the flux in the air gap is trying to reduce, and this reduction is opposed by damper bar winding flux and field winding flux. Okay, see, in transformer also, if the current reduces here, if the current reduces from T2 to T3, the flux will try to reduce, but the secondary winding will produce counter flux. Since the resistance is zero, the opposition will be more, so this flux will not allow the main flux to reduce. Okay, so it will take more time to reduce. That's why here also the damper bar winding flux and the field winding flux will not allow the air gap flux to reduce from FF to FR instantaneously, right? It will take more time. So under this period we have read about transient condition. Okay, so the moment short circuit appear, that region that condition was subtransient condition. At that condition your current was IF. Okay, that condition was, in that condition current was IF. Okay, after the subtransient region where the effect of damper bar winding is eliminated, the effect of field winding was there. After the transient region, both the effect of damper bar winding and the effect of field winding is eliminated, then your system will be in steady state condition. Okay, so this is the concept behind short circuit of synchronous machine or transient behavior of synchronous machine. Okay, see, we always do short circuit analysis for synchronous generator. Okay, synchronous generator or alternator. Okay, but not for motor. Okay, but not for synchronous motor. Why? Because if fault occur, suppose if fault occur at this point, then this is a problem for generator, not for the load. Okay, I have already explained you while solving question, while solving short circuit KVA and short circuit current, that if fault occur at any point, then the equipment will get affected which is connected to generating side. Okay, suppose fault occur at this point. And this is the transformer. Let me make it again. So suppose fault occur after the transformer. After first transformer. Okay, suppose fault occur at this point. So this will be the problem for this transformer and generator, but not for secondary transformer. Okay, that's why we always do fault analysis for generating side, not for the load side. Okay. So this is all about fault in synchronous machine.